Hello, everybody. This is Gary. Today is May 7th, 2020, Thursday. It is 3:38 p.m. Eastern Standard Time in the United States in Rochester, New York. And I wanted to do a quick video on a murder that took place back in February in Georgia. There's a video out circulating around of a black man who was just jogging down the street, was stopped by two white men who are armed with a pistol and a shotgun. And they accused him of being a robber or a burglar. And they got into a scuffle with the gun, and the black man, the jogger, was killed. I saw the video from several different angles, and it looks like the black man was murdered because he was black. This is a racist murder through and through. If you look at the video, you can see that he was just jogging down the street and he wasn't doing anything. There was no reason to believe he actually committed a crime. The people who shot him didn't witness him committing a crime. If they said they did, they were lying about that because there's only one burglar in that recent area, in that area recently. And this was just a like a posse hunting down a black man and deciding to kill him with guns. Maybe they didn't follow him with the exact intention of murdering him, but they were armed. He was just a jogger, and it ended up that the man got killed because he was just defending himself. He saw two white men with guns, and he decided to defend himself, and he got shot and killed in the process. This was a racist profiling case through and through. This was just murder. There's no way to justify what the police, or actually, one of the people who killed this black man was a retired police officer from Georgia and his son. And the person making the video, it's not exactly clear who made the video. It might have been a third person who was part of that posse who decided to accuse this black man of committing a crime and trying to stop him when there's no evidence that they witness him committing a crime. That's bullshit. Georgia law allows for citizens arrest under narrow conditions that are not met in this case. These three white guys, presumably three white guys, had no right to stop this black man in the middle of the street and pull out guns on him. If somebody pulled the gun on me, it would be instinctive for me to defend myself and try to fight because I would feel like my life was in danger. And sure enough, this is what the black man did. I believe his name was Ahmad Berry. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong, but I'll put a link in the description to the video, and you can watch the video and judge for yourselves.